think I'll add another for the planet to chill with. Cause I'm the chill one, known to get ill when they step to the hill wrong, so I had to kill one. Now I'm headed up the river with a bow and a paddle, and they got me in lockdown. Headed up the river with a bow and a paddle, and they got me in lockdown. Living like a nigga who done lost his mind, cause I ain't going out like a spineless jellyfish. Some say life is a bitch, ask that punk who duck is a bitch. Up on the hill fucking up at a party, tried to get funny, put a hole in his body. La 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 la. Look at all of those funeral cars, cause I'm a shot on shotgun, head on a pub, left front on a 40. Pump my shotgun, la 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 la.
Ross Status TV, hit that thumbs up. Cypress Hill, early 90s, Hand on the Pump. If you remember like I do, Cypress Hill was very popular. If you're from Generation X like me, you may have felt like me. I was never really okay with them using the N-word. After all, you ain't black. Now, what does that mean? Rap, from its beginning, was anti-white supremacist system. But you see, when these Latinos like Cypress Hill from Los Angeles, California, when they got a chance to make their own video, to make some music, they said, sawed off shotgun, hand on the pump, pump my shotgun, the niggas didn't jump. They didn't say the beaners didn't jump. They didn't say the cholos didn't jump. They didn't say the essays didn't jump. They didn't say the wetbacks didn't jump. They said the niggas didn't jump. So in a black revolutionary art form like hip hop, they chose to inject their view of the world, which was a cholo running up on a black dude in a bar and gunning him down. You see, we need to understand what we're dealing with these descendants of the Spanish Empire, these bastards of the conquistador rapists. Spanish rape babies. That's not a diss. That's not hate. You understand the thousand-year historic animosity between those that are called Spanish, those that are regarded as Afrikoid. So Cypress Hill from Priority Records, which was owned by Brian Turner, which was later absorbed by, I believe, Capitol or Sony Music, a bigger label. Forgive me, I can't remember exactly which mega label. But you understand that while we're up here making friends with everybody, I got people in my comment sections on my previous videos. A lot of dudes out here are hurt. They don't understand warfare. They don't understand that people have a different view of the world than you do. They look at you as the enemy. They look at you speaking out against white supremacy as an attack on them, because inside of their minds, they're white. They think they're connected to the Spaniards. So Be Real, who was a mediocre rapper, a mediocre rhymer. The beats were fire, can't front. Again, decided to express his real thoughts and also visualize what was on their minds. That was attacking a black man after using a black art form to enrich themselves. You see, there's no honor in these different cultures. The creative thing, the I'm not gonna bite thing, I'm gonna come up with my own thing, that is black culture, in particular black American culture. Whereas others, those non-blacks, have a culture of, let me see what the black people are doing and let me bite, and then use it against them, weaponize it against our historic enemy. Ross Status TV. So let me know what you think. Do you remember this video? May have thought nothing of it back then. Or perhaps in the back of your head, you were like, nah. Because for people that walk like us, talk like us, act like us, make music like us, dance like us, it's almost a foreign concept to us for someone to bite, which is a form of homage, and then attack. But on the other hand, it's not a form of homage. It's an act of war to steal your good ideas and use it against you. Raw Status TV, thumbs up.